Sacrifice is a word we all know too well. There is no one within the sound of my voice who has not lost someone. A wife, husband, children, friend, lover. But there is one thing we must never lose. Hope.
25 years ago, when I say it out loud, it's I can't believe it's been that long. But then again, sometimes that's how it is as you move, I think, as you get older. But to see that so many fans are still interested in the show and still remember so many things about the show is always a treat. It was a unique show at the time. It's a unique show today. It holds up over time. The show is very special to me as an actor. I did many things as an actor. I played an American icon. I got to play Davy Crockett. But Captain Power was uniquely mine. And it holds a very special place in my heart, as I think it does the other cast members too.
Captain Power always has had a special place with me. It was one of the most important things that I think that I was able to do at the peak of my prior company when I was the founder of Landmark. It's great to create something 25 years ago that I think I really believed in, we all believed in, and still appreciated today. It's very, very gratifying to find people that are now in the industry. Some of them are in development, some of them are at studios, some of them are other filmmakers, who not only remember Captain Power fondly, but that also want to see it come to life again. And so that's very gratifying to know that something you created then is embraced and loved, not just as something of the past, but as something that we can rebirth today in a whole new way.
It was a time of darkness and destruction, a time of dread. Thanks to the twisted designs of a single man, the machines meant to end war for all time instead became the executioners of civilization. Humanity's history tells us such times produce heroes and heroines dedicated to turning back the darkness. And so it was in the 22nd century, the age of the machine.
I always felt that at the right time that Captain Power would get another go, and it looks like it actually might happen, and I'm very, very excited about that.
Last year we released the complete series collection of Captain Power of the original show, and the question we kept hearing from fans was, are you going to do a new version? Are you going to put out a new Captain Power show?
We've launched a new website, www.captainpowerreturns.net, gotten absolutely fantastic feedback from fans, but the biggest news of all is that we are developing a new show.
I'm very excited about it, and we've been able to assemble a really great creative team that is helping to bring this new vision to life in a totally new way.
Yeah, we're really thrilled to have the writing team of Judy Ann Garfield, Reeve Stevens as our creative partners on this show. They have a long history in the science fiction genre. They've also done incredible work on really big sci-fi franchises like Star Trek and Primeval. So when it came time to make a decision about who we were going to make this show with, we couldn't think of anyone better than Judy Ann Gar.
Captain Power and the Soldiers of the Future was a show that was definitely ahead of its time. And that time is now. When you think of all the things that were just wacky science fiction at the time of the original show, and now we're surrounded by artificial intelligences.
And the singularity is coming.
We have automated drones that are making the decision to fire on their own. We have automated warplanes that are taking off from aircraft carriers. Artificial intelligence controls our financial markets. All it's going to take is one little spark get all those things working together to remake the world for them, not for us. So Captain Power's time is now. We're not fixing Captain Power.
We're beginning it again.
With a premise pilot, and we're going to show exactly how this world came to be, how the Metal Wars started, that one particular moment. All the characters are back. We have Jonathan, we have Lyman, we have Scout, we have Pilot, Mentor, we have Eden 2, we have the Power Base.
And
we have the vault, which might be new.
We can explore, and it gives even more meaning to anybody who watched the original Captain Power. They will now see those beginnings.
And we'll be able to explore Pilot and Captain Power. Is it possible for a young woman who grew up in the Dread Youth to actually shake free of her conditioning. One thing the original show presented was the richness of the universe and yet couldn't go too deeply into it. That's what we now have the opportunity to do.
And it's always wonderful to see how a team of heroes comes together.
Yeah.
I've seen a script. I've seen a Bible. These are things that I just couldn't believe when I was seeing them. I think is going to blow a lot of people away if it comes to fruition. And the fact that I am involved in that on certain levels is very exciting. And I think it's going to be exciting for anybody who gets a chance to see it.
If there's one symbol that stands out from the original Captain Power and the Soldiers of the Future, it's that symbol of the Phoenix. And so that's what this next evolution of Captain Power is going to be. It's going to be Phoenix Rising.
We can really bring to this what I had hoped to bring to it first time around. It really is its own universe. From the power base to Volcania to Eden 2, it's a complete universe which really should be reimagined and brought to life with today's technologies, because this was an idea that was definitely ahead of its time and the technology was playing catch up to make it happen. Now, really, anything we envision, we can create, and it would be great to revisit that.